Patient's room. I have ICU and a little bit of our step down tonight, so I'm proning tonight, so I know that I'm gonna have to dedicate a little bit more time. So I came and I did like my normal vents first, and then I'm gonna go ahead and head over and do my proning patient. That way I can spend a little extra TLC with them. So I just completed my first round and I'm gonna go ahead to put dinner.
Mr. Brown and the piano.
Okay,
we're
missing
one.
Are we?
Yeah. So I just finished with my next set of rounds, supine to my patient. Now I am back to break in.
You know that?
Gave it up to somebody who didn't deserve my body. You gon' have to let it show that help me kill this thing over.
So it is currently 10:04. We were at the ER at like 4 o'clock. So we were there for quite a while. It was that weird time, like, kind of where, like, once we got there and stuff, like, I kept hearing the ambulance come through. And then my shift, like, my coworkers were getting off of work and, like, changing shifts. So, you know how that goes. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, and I was trying not to pull the whole, like, I work here card, you know, working here like that. Like, I think I've been out there, like, one time. So, they don't know me. So, I didn't want to be, like, an asshole. Like, I work here. Take me in. You know what I mean? I did finally see my coworker, and he was like, yo, like, why are you waiting in the waiting room? And took us to the back, which was great because we were in and out pretty fast after that. We don't have the results for his tests yet. They swabbed him for RSV, COVID, like good jazz. It was more for me, like I took him to the ER, not so much for the fever, which he did have a fever of 103 for 2 days. But it was more because, I can't see that far. It was more because he had this allergic reaction, which I will input a picture here. Where it was like he had two black eyes, and I was like, the fuck. So that I just was like, well, I haven't used anything differently on him, so I just want to know what it is, like, to make sure this is not anything like more than just like, you know, like a common cold or a virus or whatever. But we're starving because we ran out the ER. Hold on real quick. Let me order some food. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, so just decided, like, you know, not decided, but I was like, well, let's just get something to eat before we go home. Because like I said, we've been there since 3 o'clock, so we missed dinner. All we had was some cookies, and he had Gatorade in the ER. So I know he's fucking hungry, but now he is knocked out. Arm droop for me. Yeah, so that was fun. So I get to take a little breaky break. I am in COVID ICU, and we actually have a breaker tonight. So I get to have a 15-minute break. And
It's more crazy because CJ is at home sick. I spent the whole night in the hospital yesterday, making sure he didn't have COVID or RSV or the flu, which he had none of, which was crazy because like I was telling you guys, like, he was legit, and even today he's still running like 103, and I'm here at work because I can't call off no more because all these motherfuckers want to keep getting sick and I gotta keep calling off, and I don't look like a bad person because, you know, I'm new still here. So all right guys, this is day 5. CJ is still low-key running a fever. It has been a long weekend, okay? Like I said, I spent like 6 hours in the ER the other night not getting paid. For them to COVID test him, RSV test him, even though he's a little old, flu test him. Like, I wanted them to do my hair, dog. I wanted them to test him for everything because, like, you know, I have the other boys at home and I don't want him to, like, get them sick and they're in school. So I just didn't know anything. And so everything came back negative. And so they were just like, you know, keep treating it with Tylenol, alternate Tylenol, Motrin. And I've been doing that. But this morning, so it's Wednesday. And so this morning we woke up and he was like screaming about his throat hurting. So now I'm like, oh, okay, maybe it's strep. We didn't test for strep. So we are actually going to go to the doctor's office at 10:30. And I'm trying. we're going to the doctor's office at 10:30 so that they can, you know, swab him again and then... you know, do like a urine test and blood work just so that we can see where we're going. Clearly there's some type of infection somewhere. We don't know where, otherwise he wouldn't be having a fever for this many days. So there's that. So I just finished dropping off the other boys at school because like I kept them home for like, I kept them home Monday and Tuesday just because like, I don't want to send them to school, even though they haven't shown any like symptoms, no fevers, no cough, no nothing. I don't want to send them to school and then they spread germs to other kids, but this has been since Friday, so they haven't gotten sick, knock on wood, you know, God forbid they do get sick, but they haven't gotten sick. They have not had fevers or anything like that. So I was like, you know what? I can send them to school. I'll just keep CJ home, you know, and we'll go from there. And everybody is COVID negative. Like, we've all been COVID swabbed again. CJ has 2 negative swabs. Everybody has 2 negative swabs, actually. So we're COVID negative. So I don't know. So we're gonna figure out what it is, what's going on. Cause this is quite annoying. Yeah. But in the meanwhile, let me just go ahead and show you what I got going on. I just picked out something for CJ to put on, you know, a little Marvel shirt that I got from H&M. Yeah, H&M, Gap pants, H&M, Old Navy. If you guys watched my stories, you guys seen how fucked up my house was yesterday. And I cleaned up so good, and now it is the exact same, honey. It's a little pack. Like this, comes like this, and it has like different vitamins. Those two are the same, but like, you know, it's really cool. I could just put it in my lunch bag. And then I have Good Morning, and then I have my apple cider vinegar gummies, which these taste really good. If you guys have not tried these are bomb. They don't taste like crap. Who didn't get to eat? Who didn't get to eat? And then I also have these GABA tablets. It's supposed to help with like anxiety and stuff, like naturally help with anxiety and focus. I feel like they do, I don't know. And he's up, you see, he's not like feeling like crap, even though he's trying to pretend. Does your throat still hurt? Huh?
Not anymore.
It could be because, well, anyways, we're gonna get ready to go to the doctor. I'm gonna make him some breakfast. Totally fine.
You're not a baby.
Don't let me go. Oh, don't let me go.